week was the exact opposite. Starting off with a sour note, but culminating in his first goal in 11 games. For Tommy Soderstrom, the entire week was a pretty good one. And the Islanders hope it continues against the Montreal Canadiens. Up next. Memorial Coliseum in Uniondale, New York, the Islanders' home ice surface, and the visitors tonight are the Montreal Canadiens, the once high-flying Montreal Canadiens, the team that has Patrick Waugh in goal, the team that has beaten the Islanders twice at the Fabled Forum in Montreal, and now come into the Nassau Coliseum. Hi, everybody, I'm Jiggs McDonald with Ed Westfall and Stan Fischler, and the former Montreal Canadian great, Boom Boom Geoffrion, is with us tonight. This is not the Montreal Canadiens team that everybody expected. They're reeling after what's happened in the last two games.
They are, Jason. When you talk to the coaching staff, they don't know who's going to show up. They know who's going to show up on the lineup, who the players are going to be, but they don't know whether they're going to show up and play or not, and that's one of the problems that the Montreal Canadiens are facing right now. And with the Islanders and the Montreal Canadiens, they both played 18 games.
And the stories are brought to you by Meineke. And the Montreal story, yes, they're shell-shocked. 94 shots against in the last two games. 53 last night. Highest number ever against the Canadiens team. And what about this? 13-1. Don't like those odds. The goals against in those two games. 13 for the opponents. Only one for Montreal. And only one of the 13 were on the power play. Mere mortal. And you can put a question mark on number three because we're talking about Patrick Waugh. He's faced 86 shots in his last two games, given up 13 goals, seven of them against Philadelphia, half a dozen last night.
And when you look at Patrick Waugh, you look at his record in the last 11 hockey games, he's 4-5-2, and that's not going to be acceptable to him.
No, and they're going to come back with Ron Tugnutt in tonight's hockey game against the Islanders. And the Islanders stories, Beers. Bob Beers, signed as a free agent in the offseason, an offensive defenseman. Picked up from the Edmonton Oilers, actually signed away from Edmonton in the offseason and then suffered that injury in the mini-training camp. He'll make his first appearance tonight, becomes the 11th defenseman to play this season. So, who's next? Coming up from Denver, hard to say, but there's a name that sticks in there, Marinucci, and there's also the name Medill. Both are forwards. They've pretty much depleted the defense corps in Denver as well. Even Stevens, Stephen Thomas. Stevie, after 11 games without a goal, connected here on Saturday night against Pittsburgh. He said he could feel the weight of the world lifted off his shoulders when the puck finally went in. It wasn't beautiful, but it counted.
Doesn't matter to him. He just wanted to get that one so that he can get on with the next batch of them, and that's what he's hoping for.
Stevie and his Islanders up against these Montreal Canadiens here tonight. Crowd still filing in as we settle back to see the Islanders and the Canadiens. Let's get you back to our coverage after this.
New York Islanders hockey is brought to you by Bud Ice, the official beer of the NHL. Buy the Discover card. It pays to discover. The card that pays you back. By Volvo. Volvo reminds you to drive safely. And by Nobody Beats the Wiz. For state-of-the-art home electronics, computers, cameras, music, movies, and more, Nobody Beats the Wiz.
Every year, one credit card gives you something other credit cards don't. Only the Discover card offers you cashback bonus award. Cash. Over $500 million paid so far. And there's no annual fee. So carry the Discover card.
nothing to prove.
Your cash flow. It pays to discover. Accept it wherever you see the Novus Network sign.
O can be one-on-one, or O can be two. O is what holds companions together. O is the Olympus Stylus Zoom, a weatherproof compact camera with 2x power zoom. At Nobody Beats the Wiz, you'll find all the Olympus cameras and accessories, like the Olympus IS3 Zoom Lens Reflex Camera that zooms from telephoto to wide-angle in pin-sharp focus. With Olympus and Nobody Beats the Wiz, you'll never miss another O.
In the years to come, thousands of people will be protected because of a significant innovation from Volvo. Volvo introduces the world's first side impact airbag. Drive safely.
Bob Papa back in the Sports Authority Game Time Studios. 2 minutes until face-off after period one. Ranger highlights from the Garden, and we'll check in on the Knicks. But now we check in with the hockey maven and Boom Boom. Take it away, Stan.
Patrick Roy got bombed twice. Everybody wondering, should he start or not? And if you were the coach of the Canadiens, would you start Roy or Ron Tugnutt?
I put Roy right back in the net. He gets paid to stop the puck. He didn't have stop six shots yesterday. And as a matter of fact, why blaming the goaltender? 51 shot. What was the rest of the team, having a hot dog? I mean, how can they do that? Roy now is going to lose confidence. They don't play until next Saturday or Friday. Now, I'm glad for the kid. I hope the kid does well. I doubt it very much.
Okay, it's going to be Tugnutt. Jiggs?
Yeah, it is, Stan. And here's our starting goaltender matchup for starter. 27-year-old, his fifth appearance. There's his record on the year, 1-0-1. His last start was February the 23rd. That was a 5-2 win over Florida. Tommy Soderstrom has played every minute against the Canadiens in the Islander Nets this season. Game under 500 and a 2.54 goals against average. He'll be backed up by Jamie McLennan. Of course, Patrick Waugh is the backup goaltender for Montreal tonight. Paul Dvorsky, the referee. He's referee number 10. Linesmen are Gord Brossaker and Kevin Collins. Canadiens in the traditional blue, blanc, rouge uniforms are to the left and the Islanders to the right.
I have a quick trivia question for you, Jake. When's the last time you saw three officials, none of them with a helmet on?
Well, it's been a while, hasn't it? I can't tell you. Immediately, Jacque Demers, the Canadiens coach, has changed getting the recce line off the ice. Well, the Islanders come through the middle. Ray Ferraro handling the puck. Got checked in the play by Racine. King with one that went wide on a backhander. Shot right off the pad by the Montreal defenseman. Just lifted it right at Tugnutt from no more than 5-6 feet.
They must be very nervous, Jiggs. They're talking about it now. Wow, Tugnutt holding the edge of the goal. His own defenseman fires the puck at him. Good move here as Ray Ferraro charged through. Derek King mishandled the puck here. Did not get a shot away, but there's the puck. They tried to clear it behind the net. They shot it at the goaltender.
It may have been DiPietro. I think it was the forward coming back. I pointed the finger at the defense, but I think it was the center iceman on this line. DiPietro has the puck here and then plays it to the left side off Oleg Petrov. With Luongo back for the Islanders. Up the left wing board toward Derek King. Held in by the Canadiens. They set up the point. Van Popovic and his shot hit Ferraro's stick. Bounces to the blue line and dumped in wide to Tommy Soderstrom. DiPietro puts it back in the net. Malakhov up the left wing board. Ferraro can't get it out of there. This is Petrov turning for the Canadiens. Long shot from the point. Steered aside by Soderstrom. And brought down the left wing boards and cleared out by Vladimir Malakhov. The Canadiens have shot it right back in and they'll go for a player change. That's Chris Luongo with the outlet toward Derek King. He lifts it down the boards and now the Islanders will get a chance to change up. The police Brisois back for Montreal. He's number 43. Flushed from behind the net by Zigmund Palffy. Brisois pass picked off by Turgeon. The Canadiens covered quickly in their own zone and now they've cleared it out. And off Domfus's stick. Picked up by Palffy. Palffy over the Montreal line, only to be checked. Here's Kirk Muller. Muller unable to get through center ice cleanly. Palffy has dumped the puck in. Chasing it is Brisbois. Tugnutt left it back to the net. Comes around to the near side. Turgeon trying to center it. Turgeon puts it out. Palffy's shot is turned aside by Tugnutt. This is Domfus. into the middle, but the pass was a bad one, headed for Mark Recchi. Dennis Faske, the one constant on that list of defensemen that we showed you inside the game, is playing here with Dean Chenault. As Muller gets into the Islander zone, the pass to Recchi, put it in front. Tom Booth was well covered by Palffy. Now it comes out in front again. Dean Chenault has taken his man down, and the first penalty of the game goes to the Islanders.
First scoring opportunity on Tommy Soderstrom. Off that same play, Dean Chenault. He knew he was going to get it. Looked at the referee, hoping that he wasn't going to see the signal. But it's got to be a holding penalty. Jacque Demers. I was asking the other night, I was watching the television, I said his hair looked a little orange, but then I remember saying something up in Montreal when we were up there, and yes,
we blamed the monitor, didn't we?
Yes. We thought maybe it was just the television set, but it's not true. Saw him before the hockey game, and it does have a little different.
Yeah, a little tinge there, a tint.
That's something Lorne doesn't have to really get too concerned about.
Well,
just take a look. You don't need a replay.
Change it out for holding at the 2:08 mark. The Canadiens who come into tonight's game. And the power play that is ranked fourth on the road and fifth overall in the National Hockey League. Get it out there against the Islanders. And they've got a Bure in the lineup. And he's got the puck right now. Larry Bure can't get around Luongo. Galgano shoots it down the ice. Gotta tell you the Bure story when we get a chance. They're excited, I guess, about being called up. He didn't bring any equipment. Matthew Schneider moves the puck to the left side. Domfus is offside, and we can tell you the whole story now. Bure got the call. Conroy was sent back to their farm team at Fredericton, and Bure just went to the airport, apparently bought his own ticket, got on the plane, just figured, well, you know, they'll look after getting the equipment there. Wrong.
Had his skates in his hand?
Yeah. Well, no, he didn't have anything.
Nothing.
No, he got here to New Jersey yesterday afternoon, didn't have anything, apparently. Did find a hotel.
Then he
is a youthful-looking kid, isn't he?
He looks like a choir boy, not a hockey player.
So excited to go to the arena, even though he didn't have any equipment. He left his wallet in the hotel room last night.
That's nervous.
Oh, he's got a bit of a problem, all right.
They got him listed as 5'10".
No, don't believe it.
Not
even on the metric system. Flatley trying to dig the puck out of the corner, but Muller controls for Montreal. Got checked by Vasky. Snyder covering the left point. Feeds it back to Racine. Centered one, but well wide of anybody in a red, white, and blue uniform. So Benoit Hogue gets to the puck and clears it off Schneider's stick, covering the blue line. 45 seconds remaining in this Montreal power play. Schneider hard around the boards. That'll skip to the far side and away from Domfus and away from Schneider momentarily. He's Racine with a pass here. Off Domfus and offside as well at the Islander blue line. Clock is down to 31 seconds and the penalty against Chenault.
Well, the wrecking ball. I suppose he's one of the few players that they look to on the Montreal team that is playing somewhere near the capability that he possesses. Recchi is leading the team in scoring right now. He has 6 goals. He leads them in goals as well. 9 assists, 15 points, although he's a minus 11.
Turgeon at center ice for the Islanders. Bure is on the right side with Savage in the middle. And across the line handling the puck here is Brunet, the other forward for Montreal. Brunet tied up with Malakhov. Turgeon trying to fly it off the board. Malakhov got to it, gets it to Turgeon, who's out of there with Marty McGinnis over on the right side. They crisscross. Turgeon picked up by Brisbois, and he deflected that shot. Now Turgeon nudges it out in front, but it goes right to number 18, Larry Bure. Bure with a lot of skating skills, good puck handling, they tell me, but he got checked at center ice. This is McGinnis. Marty McGinnis dumps it in, and the Islanders are in the middle of the player change here. Travis Green has come out with Steve Thomas and Benoit Hogue. The Canadiens defenseman, Lyle Odeline, works from back of his own goal. Seemed to get crossed up a little with Bure. Odeline starts out with a feed to the left wing board. Beers stepped up to make connection with his man. Now he makes connection with the puck, and the pass went to Green, to Hogue, all the way through. Thomas with a shot that hit the side of the net. Got back by the Canadiens. Donald Brashear down the left side has dumped it in. Vasky back on it, took it away from Ed Ronan. After he got thumped solidly by Brazier, and the puck is going deep into the Montreal end. No icing to be called. Popovic been back in the net.